You should have seen his face.
Do you think that was constructive?
No.
You're certain you're taking your medication?
No.
It always comes back to one thing. The house. How can a house, just a collection of bricks, wood, and glass, have that much power over people?
You've never been there.
Well, that's true. But see, neither of you.
Really? She wanted to that house again because of you? Are you stupid? Oh, the cup of stars. Something else? Okay.
Are we going back for long?
Not yet.
Not yet? Show your hand. You had something on your hand.
I have to go back to the house and get mommy.
You went back?
Come here. Come here.
Sio, she's not touching her dad.
She fell on the floor.
Where?
You saw that?
We're in the red room.
Again?
We were in the red room having a tea party with Akin and mommy.
How? The red room's locked.
Yeah, it wasn't mommy.
Oh, you're having again one of this episode. Look! That's why she was calling every one of them asking for Loop. Move! Move, move, move! Nell! She's remembering what happened when she was looking at that bench. Oh, you have blood! A lot of blood on you!
Is she okay?
Oh!
She's okay now.
You killed her. They're going. That's fucking creepy!
It's okay, honey, I called.
Why?
Can't you see all of the blood on him?
I have to go with them now and answer some questions. But one of them is gonna stay here with you. She should be here no later than 2 o'clock.
Oh, you're giving her. Okay.
You hold on to
2 o'clock and 3 minutes. It was during that time that they all had the nightmares. I'm confused. 2 o'clock. Oh, that's not great. That's what we saw. I thought that she was hurt also. Okay, so you're gonna think that you're going crazy. You were like that? For hours? Ah! That's easy. Yes, the dad wanted that place to be closed. That was easy! Let's go. I want to meet this house now. Yes, she's calling her daddy. Light? You're seeing light? Ah! Mommy is telling you to go back home. She's not taking it with her? We saw it. We saw you dancing into that house. It was not like that. Right here, you're hallucinating.
Nelly, your mom's looking for you.
Mom?
Shirley, where's your mother?
That's it. You're having hallucinations. Welcome home. Not just come home.
No, you didn't, sweetie. We always knew.
Sio, she knew? Something is bothering me. I can buy, you know, the psychologic thing about all of what happened and is happening. The episode with Sio really changed my mind. We saw Luke seeing the monster, seeing Abigail, and we saw Sio having these powers.
We can't be late for the reception.
Reception? With all of the ghosts? They're old.
I always should have believed you about everything.
Like your wedding, you're gonna see your husband who died. Luke is here.
Thanks for believing in me, Nelly. Hi, gorgeous.
Oh no. You were dancing with him. Did she kill herself to be with her husband? Oh Nell, it hurts so much to see you like that. There are in all of the rooms the dead lady. Oh, and the Hills family also. It's not real, Nell. Nell.
Hello?
Abigail?
Come on. We're going to have a tea party.
With Luke and Abigail. During that night, Luke said that it was their mom, but Nell said that it wasn't her. Are you gonna fall? That's how you're gonna kill yourself? You're gonna hang yourself right here? Or you're gonna jump?
Nelly.
No! She's gonna put it around her neck because of the mom. It's not a necklace. No, no. She's gonna push you. Fuck! Are you? I mean, the burnt neck lady, it was her since the beginning? That's why you were saying no, 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 like that. We have to add an all new theory about all of what is happening with a time traveler's thing. Obviously, like the welcome home, come home Nell thing, what was written on the wall. And with that thing about Nell being haunted by herself, in fact, since the beginning, since she was young, she was haunted by herself being an adult, killing herself by, you know? I didn't see that coming at all, you know, the fact that she was haunted by herself, in fact, since the beginning, I didn't see that coming at all. Great, really, it's a good job with that. Woo, that was something, and that was something great. I mean, for an horrific stuff, it's really well written. But for the theory about all of what happened and is happening, I'm totally lost. If we are adding something with time travelers, time jump, and stuff like that, we are going on another level, you know, and another step, another pass. Okay, let's keep the things, the facts. The dad left the house with the kids. He was trying to save them. The mom was still in the house. Something crazy was happening into the house. Luke said that he went to drink tea with Abigail and his mom on this red room. Nell said that it wasn't their mom. Sio, she saw something but she didn't say what. Shirley, she didn't say what she saw, and Steve didn't see anything. The dad went back into the home, and when he came back, he had a lot of blood on him, and he said that the mom killed herself. Can we really believe him? I'm not sure of that. The first things that he said to the police was about a supernatural thing, and then it was about the mom killing herself. Nell, she's having, I don't know how to say it in English, sleeping paralysis or sleep paralysis. Okay, she's seeing in fact herself being like that since the beginning. Really, to add that time traveling thing, it's really an all new level that we have to, that I have to wonder about, you know. The man with the hat, we saw him, you know, in the pictures of the Hills family. It was the dad. So in fact, Luke is seeing the dad since the beginning. But the two persons that Mrs. Dudley named, I'm not remembering their names. I think that one of... No, I'm not remembering their name. But she didn't name someone who was calling Abigail or Clara. She didn't say Abigail or Clara for mentioning that little girl or the mother. My theory for now is the fact that this house, we are having a lot of ghosts in this house who are haunting the house, but who are also haunting the persons who are living into the house. And when the persons who are living into the house are going somewhere else, they are still haunting them until they are coming back home to Hill House to die. That's my theory for now. But I can't explain the time traveling thing, and I can't neither totally forget the psychological thing also behind some of the characters. We are still like, maybe she killed herself, or maybe she was haunted by her mom and her mom pushed her to kill herself, and in fact it was an evil entity who was doing that. I don't know, but I'm still like, with all of what happened to Nell and because of Nell and with Nell, I can't like erase the psychological theory about just this house getting them crazy, you know. Without the episode about Theo, I would be like 50-50. 50% for the supernatural theory, 50% for the psychological theory. But because of the episode about Theo, because we are seeing her having, you know, these feelings about what happened because she's touching someone or something, I can't ignore that, you know. I can't ignore that they're showing us really that the supernatural theory is working with her. She's having this feeling, this instinct. I'm gonna be like, okay, we are going on to the supernatural theory because of that. If they are telling to the viewers it's happening, Theo is having this thing, okay, we are on a supernatural show, you know. So I have to consider that everything supernatural which is happening can exist, can happen. But this episode about Nell was okay, supernatural things, but also a lot psychological things. So that's why now I'm disturbed, you know, about that. And if we are adding to that the time traveler things, my mind is exploding. I don't know, I have to think about that a lot, you know, before telling you really my new theory about all of that. For now, yes, my main theory about all of that is this house is haunted by the persons who lived into that house before. When you are still alive and you are living that house is working for you to come home and to kill you. That's my theory for now. And that's why Nell is seeing the Hills, I mean the family, the Hill family, into her hallucinations. And that's why she's seeing also Abigail. Maybe we had two families before them being into that house. She's seeing the Dudley's family also. Are they real or not? That's it, I'm lost. Don't tell me in the comments. I mean, if you watched already the show and if you know the answers, please don't tell me the answers in the comments. But if you are binge watching the show with me, If you have theories about that, you can tell me your theories on the comments. But please, if you know the answers, don't tell me. Okay, so it's all for today for me and for you for The Haunting of Hill House. I don't know when I'm gonna watch the other episodes, I don't know. But I hope that, you know, when I'm gonna be back for The Haunting of Hill House, I'm gonna have a clear mind about all of what I saw and what I can really have as a theory that can work with all of what happened and is happening now for them. Right now I'm totally lost, but yes, it's all for today because you can see it, maybe it's already the night. It was really a day for watching the show, you know, it was really the mood for watching this show with this weather, with this day. Don't be worried, you know, I'm not gonna be scared all of the night because of this show, no, it's not working on me like that. I mean, I love horror shows and movies and they are not really working on me like that. I'm not having nightmares because of it or stuff like that, so don't worry about me. Okay, so it's all for you and for me for today, and it's all for me for now, so bye for now, bye!
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me that you built a time machine?